Okay. The next play will be And Then the Bullhorn Crackles by Michael Shaeffer. D will be played by Cory, and E will be played by
Maybe I just don't like Mondays. I said, maybe I just don't like...
Is that supposed to be funny? Is that an attempt at humor?
Well, what is it that makes you laugh? What do you find hilarious? Stephen Colbert, Ellen DeGeneres, the Book of Mormon?
Chelsea Handler, I suppose.
Digestibius nonis disputandum. That's Latin for...
I know it's Latin. And I know what it means.
Do you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean to do?
I know that you must feel angry and scared and alone. I think you are sick and in need of some help. Will you let me help you?
No. Not yet.
What is it that you want?
What I want? Like a list of demands, or just what I want from you? I want a place to hide until it gets a little darker outside, and then I'll leave you. Do you believe me?
I want to believe you. I maintain that you are in need of help.
Do you have a Facebook account? I'm guessing the odds are pretty good that you do. And how many friends do you have? 500? 600? More? It's nothing to be ashamed of. You should own your own virtual popularity.
I don't know how many.
But you do have a Facebook account.
Yes.
The reason that I ask, in light of recent events, is that I don't have a single friend. Even before. Do you know what that's like?
If you broke into my home in the interest of making a new friend, I'm afraid I'm going to have to disappoint you. Flatly. You need to go. I can't have you here. The police!
I saw the police officers. The ones who knocked on the door about an hour ago and then left 5 minutes later. Fairly tall man and the short Rubenesque woman who really needs to lay off the apple fritters, but those police officers, I don't think that the police will be back to check up on you or your neighbors anytime soon, not unless I want them to. You think that I want them to? Okay. Stand up. Give me a hug.
I don't understand.
What's to understand? You have 420,000 Facebook friends, and I have none. And I've been shot. Clearly, I need a hug. Do you have any brothers or sisters?
I have a brother. A twin.
A twin brother. When was the last time you saw him?
Easter.
I want you to pretend that you haven't seen your brother in years. Or better yet, imagine you're going to see him for the last time in your life. Now, pretend that I'm him. I want you to hug me like I'm your brother. Really. Hug me. Hug me like it's the only thing that will keep him alive. Now tell me, what do you feel?
I feel scared?
No. What do you feel?
I feel You have something strapped to your chest, in your back, and you're still bleeding. I think you need medical attention.
Yeah. Correct on all accounts. We better sit down again. Please, sit down. Sitting is less stressful, and I'm a stress-free kind of guy. Thank you. Thank you for the hug, and here's your phone back.
Help me understand.
It was just so much easier than we thought it would be. There was a volunteer at the finish line dressed in a Tom Brady jersey. I know, what are the odds, right? He had a stopwatch in one hand and a huge coffee mug in the other. He was sitting near a microphone stand, just oblivious. I resisted the urge to check the connections one last time and just dropped off the double play. I remember seeing this gaudy, shiny jersey and thinking about just what it means to be a patriot, to be a true patriot. And I wondered if that slob had any clue what the word even means. And I remember thinking how disgustingly perfect the moment was. You think I'm a monster? Or a sociopath? Well, you won't have to put up with me much longer. I'll be leaving here soon. Perhaps I can teach you a song, though, before we part. The song of a true patriot. You're not singing along? I admit it lacks the flutter and wow of Justin Timberlake or Ani DeFranco, but your American artist just would never capture the nuances of the Chechen anthem. It's very majestic, loosely translated the title, the lyrics mean death or freedom.
Well, of the two, I hope you get the one you most deserve.
They killed my brother! He didn't deserve it.
Your brother killed four people. He shot down a police officer. During your moment of disgusting perfection, he blew up an innocent 8-year-old boy. If you think that your brother is enjoying anything less than an eternity riding side saddle on Satan's dick, you are more delusional than the media imagines.
I haven't decided if I'm going to kill you or not. If I kill you, I won't have the luxury, the time, to hide your body well, even if I hide it. But the weekend is upon us. It could be Monday, Tuesday, before your body's discovered, and it won't be a pretty sight. Is there someone you'd like to call? And I gave you your phone. Are you waiting until the cheaper evening rates kick in? Don't you want to call your friends, your family, brother, boyfriend, girlfriend?
I want to call the police.
I'll not stop.
Hello, my name is Eloise Wagner. I have suspect number 2 in my apartment. Yes, that's correct.
I'll make a deal with you, Lewis. Make one more phone call, and I promise to leave here forever. But no, not with your phone. Mine.
How do I know that?
You don't. I'm not even entirely sure what will happen. That's what makes this such a unique learning opportunity. You don't know what's on the other end. Maybe it's another duffel bag nearby. Maybe we're out of range. Maybe the item in question has already been discovered and defused by the officers that stopped by earlier. But maybe it's my dad's number, although that's very unlikely. Perhaps I'm taking your advice and finally seeking help, and maybe it's... the but you gotta roll the dice.
You ready?
I dial the number and no one. Right away.
Swear to God. Four.
For whom?
The number. Four is the first digit.
Four.
Two.
Two.
Zero.
Mm-hmm.